This world is very sick right now. It needs indigenous knowledge. It needs our ways. It's native people's birthright to take care of this planet, to take care of Mother Earth. And renewable energy is the way to do it. Solar is the way to do it. I am a citizen of the Red Lake Nation in northern Minnesota. The Red Lake Indian Reservation is a very special place. Our people long ago had that foresight to keep this land intact for our grandchildren and children, and that no one should own the land. It should all be ours together. That, to me, speaks to the spirit of Red Lake and why I feel so passionate about this project.
In the United States, on average, tribal land is actually richer in renewable energy potential than non-tribal land. As the use of solar electricity is increasing across the whole country, we're definitely seeing more installations on tribal land and more interest in installation on tribal land.
You know, this colonial capitalism model is very extractive, very predatory. These communities, they've been preyed upon for so long. We need to flip the script. We need to change the game. We need to change the tables. Renewable energy could be a power source, and that could really drive community development. And so I decided that I'll go ahead and create this company called Solar Bear, and it was going to be this kind of driving force in the renewable energy field. We completed the government center. That's the Big Eagle. That's kind of like a focal and center point for the community. If there was something to happen, like say a tornado or some type of bad weather, the government can still function and serve the people of the community. So that's why that building was done first. We are now finishing up the Oshki Mijitata, which is the job training center. And the reason for that project right there is because we need to be able to have the tribal members see something tangible. Tribal members are going to be able to work with this new technology with the solar, and that's what I'm really excited about, because it's going to create careers for them. The project that we're doing in Red Lake is not only just a solar project for that community, it's also a demonstration project, right? That we can go ahead and show other communities what we've accomplished here. And if we could do that in Red Lake, imagine what we can do in other communities, not only in the state of Minnesota, but across the country. One of the main things that is plaguing tribal communities is poverty. Especially when you look at a community like Red Lake that has a median income of $8,000 to $10,000 a year. And so what if we put people to work? Like, what if we gave them purpose, but something that meant something to them?
There are not necessarily the same kinds of economic opportunities on a tribal reservation that there are across the broader society or in more urban areas of the country. And so by pursuing larger scale renewable energy projects, tribal enterprise or tribal government might be able to have another source of revenue and another source of jobs.
We have actually about 10, 12 buildings that are like part of this whole plan. Ultimately, what we would like to do is create our own renewable energy microgrid. And of course, that would be the starting block to create our own tribal utilities.
The size of the solar farm that we have planned out east is enough to power 2,500 homes. That's a lot more than on the reservation. So, you know, we're going to be exporting, you know, the power. And Native people always think about 7 generations down the road. You know, we want to be able to keep things so things are going at least for the next 7 generations. And this is a way to do it.
Fires are destroying our forests. Droughts are limiting our water sources, and our plants are dying because of that. That we gotta put a stop to this.
That's why we're doing what we're doing, because we're gonna create a future for you kids, and you kids are gonna take over. There's a new time coming, everyone, and it's gonna be led by you guys.
Oh my God, I'm like just getting all choked up here looking at you kids, because you guys are so beautiful.
This country right now is facing a number of critical and urgent challenges. And I think bringing all different perspectives to the table in solving those problems is going to be very important.
What I'm trying to do is use my cultural teachings, use the traditions that I know, and implement it into this like new way of thinking. I believe honestly that Native people are going to help save this world.